Hello, everybody. Saturday, can you hear me? Yep. Saturday, December 29th, 2016.
Thursday, but we were close.
Oh, Thursday. Seems like a Saturday. I've been off all week. I'm here. This is John Belger and Ross Annenberg with me. We're here for the swim meet. Okay, event one. I was talking to Coach King in lane four. We have the all juniors team. That includes Julia Pillarella, Brooklyn Brenner, Harley Richardson, Kelly Burke. In lane two, we have the all sophomore team relay. That's Kaylee Cohane, Amanda Mack, Sierra Schlussel, Stephanie Capellos. And in lane six, we have the all freshmen. That's Kate Lagasse, Allison Fu, Kayla McCann, and Mary Lauren Burke.
And this is the 200 medley relay. Four laps of the pool. We just completed the first lap, which was backstroke, then breaststroke, then butterfly, and to follow up the last leg of the 50 yards is the freestyle, John. And it doesn't look like Foxboro has too many members of their team, so I see this as a potential victory, but we'll have to play it out and see what happens with the members of the team. But it looks like a good experience to all the relay members. As you said, as all junior, all sophomore, and all freshman team, gives them experience. It gives them an opportunity to get their feet wet, no pun intended, in the pool, and to understand what it takes to be a hiller swimmer.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I think it's funny, the meet just got going so fast. I'm glad to see it underway. It's been a year since you and I were really on the air, and I have to say it's a welcome respite on a Thursday night.
It is, and we had some snow earlier. We hope everybody who are out there in TV land, be careful on the roads with the ice and the snow. We are in the midst of a winter season, so watch out for the roads. Respect your traffic signals and make sure you don't tailgate.
Now, I will say this, leading on to what you said a few minutes ago about, you know, Foxboro not having a big team, and I think it's a testimony to Coach King. He's mixing it up a little bit with some of the relays. You know, typically he wouldn't just have an all-sophomore, all-junior, all-whatever freshman relay teams. So I think he recognizes that, you know, the team has a good chance of winning, but he also really wants to win, and I just saw a second and third for Hopkinton in that relay. Kelly Burke, I think, just finished off that relay in lane four in first place. Lane four, Kelly Burke, yep.
As Foxboro completes their last leg of the race, we're going to go on to the boys' 200 medley. John, if you could do the honors of the combatants.
Lane two, we have Colin Fine, Sam Cody, Sam Richardson, and Jack Brennan. That has to be that's the cream right there. Lane four, Robin Chu, Jake Glover, Young John Kim, Alex Matsoukas, and lane six, Andrew DeLeva, Justin Mack, Ritesh Ranjanagan, and Fletcher Clark.
And each member of that team, as John has described, there are 12 members that are competing, each in the 2, 4, and 6 lanes. It's interesting to see the names of the individuals that are part of the Hopkinton Hillers dive and swim team, a variety of individuals from Youngju Kim all the way to Fletcher Clark. A lot of these names are made for Hollywood, John.
Absolutely.
And made for the bigger stage, so hopefully this will be a springboard into bigger and better things for these young men and women.
Yeah, one thing I think you and I both noticed in the short season so far is the boys' team is a lot bigger than in previous years. It doesn't necessarily have all the quality of previous years, but it's doing very well because it has a lot of quantity.
It does.
Yep.
It does. There's something to be said in numbers.
Absolutely. I mean, the last meet, I know the boys swam three relays alone.
Again, they start off with backstroke 50 yards, then go to breaststroke, butterfly, and then finalize it with freestyle. We'll see how it rolls in this situation. Now, this is a non-league event, so it is not a co-ed meet. It is boys and girls individual, so there'll be separate scores for the boys and girls. I'd like to go ahead and thank our volunteers already for this in advance. The timers, the scorers, the video people, the parents that are involved that make this such a successful sporting event.
Now, Russ, I don't know if you had a chance to look at the press pack, but I did notice, and this would be something you could probably help us with, that the boys aren't fielding a diving team tonight. Is that because Foxboro? Because I know Hopkinton has a boys diving group.
I don't know the history on it, so I won't. Okay. I can't speak on it with any sense of intelligence. Okay. But I presume if they don't have it, then I presume it's just because of Foxborough's limited numbers, and Coach King is confident that having girls compete alone would be enough with the individual events. But as far as I know, there are two different teams, boys and girls, as opposed to a Tri-Valley meet, which is co-ed.
Now, just going back to the race, it's looking very good for Hopkinton here. If lane six, I see that's Ritesh Ranjanagan, he can pick it up a little bit. It'll be 1-2-3 Hopkinton.
And that's sort of a mouthful, that name.
Yes. I wonder if he has a shortened version of it.
He may have an Americanized version.
Yep.
I don't think I'm speaking out of turn. That surname is probably not Anglican.
Yes. Okay, it looks like we're going to see Hopkinton 1. That was Alex Matsoukas touching first, Jack Brennan touching second, and now in the final, Fletcher Clark for Hopkinton. It's going to be a fifth place finish for them. But a very nice overall in the 200 medley relay for Hopkinton.
And as the Hopkinton Hillers cheer on, as part of their sportsmanship, they cheer on every individual combatant. Whether they're good, bad, indifferent, hardworking is part of the work ethic, and the individual from Foxboro completes his final leg of the relay.
Now coming up, we have the 200 free, girls 200 free, lane two, Julia Gorgel, lane four, Logan Salyards, and lane six, swimming against her sister, Paitlin Salyards.
And I believe there's a Salyards in attendance in the front row. So that would be a trifecta.
Absolutely. Now you can see down at the end of lane one, the girls team amassing there, or some members of the team, some boys included. I'm sure there's going to be a lot of cheering on this one. It's four lengths of the pool. Oh, no, it's 200 free. So it's, I always get the math wrong.
Eight lengths of the pool. It would be four lengths if it was 50 yards.
Yes.
That's if you're at MIT.
Lane two, Julia Gorgel. Lane four, Logan Salyards. Lane six, Paitlin Salyards. Now, typically, I would say it's sort of one of the most difficult races in girls swimming. It's not a sprint. My daughter reminds me, it's not a sprint. It's not a long distance race. You really have to keep the pressure on. The coach looks at first half splits and second half splits. But it looks very nice. The race looks very nice right now for Logan. She looks like she's in a good rhythm there. Of course, you see Coach King on the edge here. He's telling her, he's giving her a thumbs up. I'm thinking most of the time the swimmers never see any of that.
No. Well, I mean, I guess coming from a split family of divers and swimmers, there may be a swimmer that hears them every so often, but I think it's just ingrained in them that he's going to be a presence, whether there's any wavelengths and he's a dolphin and you can hear him. I doubt it.
Absolutely. very difficult race. You know, it's not a 500. 500 is a completely different thing, but
yeah, that's sort of a marathon.
Yeah, 200 is a very difficult swim. It's Logan Salyards in the front. She seems in a good rhythm there. And lane six, Paitlin. And it looks like Paitlin is tied with somebody from Foxboro. And then, of course, here in lane two, we have Julia Gorgel.
And as we look at the 200 yards, it's one of those, like you had mentioned, it's one of those hybrid type events where it's not a sprint, it's not a marathon, but it is a cardiovascular event where you need to, as you said earlier, keep the pressure on and make sure that your strokes are in form with a 200 yard type race, because if you take a lax and somebody has a better kick than you with the last 50 yards, then you may have some issues. But
ooh,
it looks
it's gonna
like
be a tight one for second.
It looks like Hopkinton finishes 1, 2, and 4. Again, I think Coach King, who's in his donning his orange and black with green shoes, has shown quite restraint and is looking at the team, trying to motivate them in different ways as opposed to your straight, I need to win this victory.
Absolutely. And I will say a lot of the kids have been sick the last couple of weeks. I don't know if you had any illness running around your house, but
I think it's just it runs across the Hopkinton town line.
Yes. And so it's good to mix it up a bit. So now we have the 200 free for the boys. Lane two, Brad Canty. Lane four, Greg Ramon. And lane six, Connor Murchie.
And just for correction purposes, for future reference, Greg Ryman.
Ryman, sorry about
That's
that.
That's okay. We're just trying to get it right so the parents don't write a letter to the editor.
Yep.
And we got a capacity crowd, at least from the Hopkinton side. There's a lot of alumni here, class of 2016, 15, and possibly 14. They usually come back and enjoy the experience with a hug from Coach King and a couple applause lines, say hello to some of the swimmers and divers that they know that are current participants, and then they go off for food. That's usually a tradition.
That's a tradition, yeah.
In the Hopkinton.
You know, it's funny, when I was in high school, it would be we were going out for drinks after that, but.
Well, let's not go there. The drinking age was 18.
At that time, even.
16, I guess, if you live in New York.
Yeah, I live in New York. That's not politically correct.
I yeah, know. No, we've changed the mores and the morals of today's society. What is Bridget competing today? Anything?
Tonight she's the 100 free and the final relay.
Is that just for qualifying times or just to get a new experience?
No, she wants the 100 free. She qualified for the sectionals in the 200 at the last meet. And so she's looking to get into the 100. Hopefully tonight she has a good swim. No pressure.
No. Well, there's no point pressure.
Nope.
There's individual time pressure, but that's different.
Yes.
I've learned that long ago.
Yeah. You know, it's a gift. I think you probably experience it with your own daughter. I mean, they put their own pressure on. I don't think they need us to. These kids want to succeed. So.
Oh, absolutely.
It's a great thing. I think it's probably a great thing for Coach King, too, because he's got a lot of motivated swimmers and divers.
And it's always a good lot of kids, academically oriented,
exactly.
Socially responsible, charitable, and obviously competitive.
Yep, absolutely.
As I noticed, two more Hopkinton individuals from the class of 2015 and 2016, respectively, Lydia Franklin, co-captain, along with Bridget Coffey, another co-captain, hugging Nicole Annenberg and Brianna Gallo, class of 2015 co-captains. Still a lot of cheering going on. This individual in lane one, he's giving it his all.
Yep.
It's one of those few sports where the participation rate is high and the excellent rate is medium and nobody cares.
Exactly.
As long as there are people in there doing their best.
Now it looks like we're finishing up here, Hopkinton. Lane four, that was Greg, pronounced
Ryman.
Greg Ryman.
Yeah, of the Ryman dynasty.
The Ryman dynasty. And in lane two, Hopkinton, second place, that was Brad Canty. And it looks like lane six, we're going to get a touch again. Connor Murchie, very nice finish there. And you can see Foxboro is still finishing up their laps. It looks like this guy in lane one may be finishing up a little bit longer than the others.
It's interesting. Foxboro, I'm not sure if they have their own pool, but what's interesting is Foxboro usually has a competitive sports program. I'm not really sure where they fit in the swimming and diving world.
Yep.
But it doesn't look like they have a lot of, at least, participants. They may have some quality athletes, but participants are really not, looks like their forte.
Definitely. So we're finishing up here, although it's going to be a little longer. But it was 1-2-3 for Hopkinton. Greg Ryman, Brad Canty, and Connor Murchie, first, second, and third.
As we look towards the next event, John?
For the 200 IM, for the girls, lane two, Mallory Pischoff. Lane four, Grace Cavanaugh. And lane six, Kate Lagasse. I would say in this race, we're looking at Grace Cavanaugh trying for some time.
She's one of those scintillating sophomores?
Yes. Coming off an excellent freshman season. I know she's been swimming all summer and fall. Her mother is at the bench, sitting down there at the scorer's table. I'm sure her mother has a clock, has a little stopwatch at her waist. Because that's how swimmers are. Now, it's funny, I didn't think that girl in lane four looked like Grace. But I could be wrong. I'm wondering if she was a late scratch, but now that I'm seeing the girl swim, I'm thinking maybe not. It's like sitting next to the mayor of Hopkinton Swim here, Ross. Oh, I confirm it. That is Grace out there. It's a good race for Mallory to be in because she's trying to make a name and she's got a good swimmer ahead of her, you know, fast swimmer. I think that usually helps with the times. And she looks very good out there, Mallory does. She's in lane two.
What year is she in?
She's a junior. Now, I'm thinking backstroke is Grace's best stroke, but I don't really know.
Well, it looked like she was pretty fluid.
Swimmer, yeah.
She was definitely pretty fluid in the breaststroke, which is a decent competitive stroke, too.
Now, I feel like the breaststroke is Mallory's best stroke, and she looks like she's pulling up on that girl in lane three. She's one of those kids, I've been watching her swim since she was like 7 years old at the Milford Stingrays.
And Grace is continuing her lead coming into the last. Last final.
Yeah, she's running a very good race right now. The sectional time on this is 2:28.74 for the girls. I'm not sure she's got it in her tonight, but it's going to be a very nice show for her tonight. You know, I could say it's early in the season, but this is a short season.
It is indeed. 12 meets, sectional states. It's over in the blink of an eye.
No, we're not seeing a sectional performance tonight. But we are seeing a first and a third. Mallory Pischoff, third place, lane two. And it looks like we might have a fourth coming up, lane six.
That's freshman Kate Lagasse.
Now, did she have brothers and stuff?
She did.
Yes, she's from a long line of swimmers.
She had twin brothers and then a younger, an older brother.
Yep.
That were
excellent swimmers, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Just graduated college. One of them still competing in college.
So now we're in the boys 200 IM. Lane two, Zach Hulbro. Lane four, Robin Chu. And lane six, Ritesh Ranjanagan. So he is getting a lot of swimming tonight.
He is. Good for him.
Because he's going to be in the 400 relay at the end. Oh, I see also Coach King put some swimmers, divers, boys divers in the 200 free relay.
Oh, did he?
Yep. As we said, lane two, Zach Hulbro. Lane four, Robin Chu. Lane six, Ritesh Ranjanagan.
And again, it's a very placid crowd after the Christmas feast. Everybody got all their shopping, gifts out of the way, and we approach the new year. This is the week between Christmas and New Year where a lot of festivities will continue on for the week. And people will be off at different levels. School is closed, but Keefe Tech is open and running.
And this is the final meet before next year.
It is indeed. We have a meet January 3rd, which is, I believe, next Tuesday.
Yep. Now, they always say that the breaststroke is the stroke that wins the IM. So
usually it's the most individualized stroke. That or the butterfly would give you an opportunity. I think the butterfly is less of a factor because it's the first leg.
Yep.
It's an important factor, don't get me wrong. But if you're a very good breaststroker and you're able to gather 3 to 5 seconds, it can overcome deficiencies in other strokes.
Yep. Now, we had an interesting conversation with Mike Cousins before from HCAM, and he was telling us how exciting
Mike Tarosian.
Mike Tarosian.
Jim Cousins
Jim
is
Cousins
his boss.
Is somebody else.
Same church, wrong pew.
Yes. And so he was saying that, you know, he does a lot of the hockey himself, I guess.
Right.
And,
he gets paid for that.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
We're volunteers.
Yes. And so he was saying how he has a lot of fun with it.
Yeah. Where are the hockey home games, you know?
I have no idea.
I know there's a arena on Fruit Street. Is that correct?
No, I don't think so.
No? There's no local one?
No. Oh, I don't know where they might play up in
Marlboro,
yeah. So it looks like first, second, and third for Hopkinton. In first place was Robin Chu, second place Zach Hulbro, and third place Ritesh Ranjanagan. And I think the depth of Hopkinton's team is showing so far in this in this meet. Now we're on to the 50 free. And we have lane two, Ansley Worrell. Lane four, Mary Lauren Burke. And lane six, Tiana McCann.
As the boys do a little wind down, the girls get ready to compete. And this is the sprinters portion of the meet where expectations are high. Hopkinton has always done well in the 50 free, boys and girls alike, in sectionals and competitive in the state. So we hopefully the tradition continues.
Yep. Now we are seeing some good times this year from some of the freshmen, and I see, I think, two freshmen in this race, Mary Lauren Burke and Ansley Worrell.
Former two-time captain Spencer Franklin is in the house, along with his wonderful mother, Julia Forte.
Yes, so in lane two, we have Ansley Worrell. Lane four, we have Mary Lauren Burke, and it's coming down to them. And Tiana McCann in third. Nice race. It's over in a blink of an eye. There's going to be a second heat here.
Now the second heat is just for experience purposes.
And in lane two, Brooklyn Brenner. Lane four, Emily Trudeau. Lane six, Amanda Mack.
Keefe Tech is the pool of choice for the Metro West area high schools, including Dover, Sherbourne, Ashland, Holliston, Hopkinton, Framingham, and Natick. So there's a lot of chlorine that is exhumed in that pool.
Absolutely. Look for a good race out of Emily Trudeau here. Looks like she's really winding up for have a good year this year.
As the Franklin, who are considered Hopkinton royalty, wave to people. Dave Franklin and his beautiful wife, Julia Forte, in the house with their two former co-captain kids.
Once again, a first, second, and third finish in the second heat. We had Emily Trudeau in first, Amanda Mack in second, lane six, and Brooklyn Brenner, lane two.
And again, that second heat is a non-point total heat, but what it does is it allows experience. And we have a running total as we look at it. The boys are 25-5 and the girls are 18-12. Again, Coach King has this all mapped out, so a prediction of what the total is just a foregone conclusion. It's just a matter of how much they win by.
Yeah, so for this we have lane two, Sam Richardson, lane four, Jake Glover, lane six, Andrew DeLeva. Andrew's had two good swims tonight. He swam the lead into the 200 medley relay, and now he's out there again for the 50 free. But I would have to say Sam has a good shot at this one. Sam is part of the Richardson royalty. But it's good experience for these kids to get in against. Although that Foxboro lane three looks very good. Whoa, lane two, Sam Richardson. looks like a photo for second place between Jake Glover and the guy from Foxboro. And then, of course, Andrew DeLeva came in third, it looked like, or fourth. So we're have second a second heat going on. So lane two, Fletcher Clark. Lane four, Justin Mack. And lane six, Jack Brennan. I see the divers over there. It looks like your daughter's going to be out there tonight. Getting ready to get going after the 50 free.
And we'll take a short break after this 50 free and resume with the diving once they prep for it and split the lanes open so there's room for the divers to enter and exit. Six dives for each individual with a cumulative total. Three judges.
Fletcher Clark gets off with a nice dive in. Lane six. Jack Brennan looks very good out there. Lane four, Justin Mack also. Looks like it might be first, second, third, Hopkinton. That's a very good sign for the meet and the future right there. Nice. Jack Brennan, lane six. Fletcher Clark, lane two. Justin Mack, lane four. So they're going to get started here. We'll come back in a couple of minutes.
And we'll be back.
So as we get our instructions from one of the diver judges, I'm going to mainly defer to. I can hear you.
I can hear you. I can't hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, you had a little technical difficulty there. So I'm going to mainly defer to Ross on this one, as I know absolutely nothing with diving.
And we have Allie Morrow competing in at number one, and we'll figure out what kind of dive she's doing with three veteran judges. And she did a basic straight dive.
Here you go. I'll take this.
Brianna Toko. Maddie Stouse is next. And looks like they're all doing the same dive.
Liam McGinnis.
Thank you.
He's a sophomore.
And then we have Jack McDonald. And then I believe Jack Brennan. Is that correct?
I think so, yeah.
Overextended himself. Not bad. I guess he didn't perform the dive that he was supposed to perform.
Yeah.
It looked like it was a pretty clean dive. And we're on dive two. Allie Morrow competing. Nice job, nice job. Concern yourself when you're doing those back dives, how close you are to the board. But Brianna hit a nice dive. Maddie's up next. Two good judges and one middle judge. Not really sure what he's looking at. Liam's second dive. Looks like the middle judge is the one who's given scores that are a little bit less. Allie Morrow on her third dive. Clean dive.
Four, six, seven.
Nice dive. Solid dive from Brianna. Good dive for Maddie. Fives. Doing fourth dive. Brianna's up next. Six and a half for Brianna. Die for Maddie straight across. Four and a half, fives. Jack Mack is up next for his fourth dive. Thank you. McKenzie's on her fifth dive. Clean dive for Brianna. She continues to. This is the hardest dive for Maddie to date. Tough guy at 5.5. This has got to hit this dive. She's pretty solid on that one. Looks like the Russian judge has finally come in form with the other two judges. Jack Max up for his fifth dive. John, it's a little hard to compete when you're not competing against anybody.
I think so, yeah.
So each kid has a different mindset. Not really sure where my daughter fits into that mindset. I think she'd rather have an opponent.
Yeah. It's like a practice event. More or less.
The good thing about it is all four girl divers are pretty consistent.
Yes.
So they push each other, but it's still good to have somebody with a different colored bathing suit.
Definitely.
Good elevation, but he just didn't get enough arc on it. Allie Morrow on her sixth and final dive. Nice dive. A little overreaching, but pretty consistent dive. After the diving portion, we'll take a short break and go to the second part of the swimming. That was a little close. She probably needs to work on that dive a little bit more because it didn't seem like it had any fluid. Solid dive. and we'll take a short break.
You're back.
I apologize for that. I was thinking that the girls were the only competitors. That was a short break. That was Liam, and we're up with Jack Mack. Final dive, a little off to the left, and Jack Brennan will complete the diving portion of it, and then we will take an official break from there.
Yeah, but before we go, we'll just express the score before the diving, I guess, right?
Absolutely, we'll give a running total. John, do the honors.
Okay, before the diving, the score is Hopkinton for the girls, Hopkinton 42. Foxboro 20, and for the boys, Hopkinton 50, Foxboro 9.
And we'll take a short break.
Take a short break, bye. Okay, we're here for the second half of the Hopkinton versus Foxboro meet. Welcome back, Ross.
Good to be back, John. We're back, and we're trying to figure out dinner arrangements. Now that we can figure out what the score is.
Yeah. Okay, we have the 100 fly, girls 100 fly. Lane 4, Abby Fisher. Lane 2, Rachel Zale. Lane 6, Stephanie Capellos.
A little delay. And they're off.
Now, obviously, very good swimmers in this heat. We have Abby Fisher. Perennially is a very good swimmer. Rachel Zale, she was sick earlier in the season and seems to have reached her form again. She's in lane 2.
Congratulations to Rachel Zale on being a part of the state championship volleyball team for the Hopkinton Hillers.
Yeah, and so she's coming back from both that and from an illness early in the season. And right now she's showing true to form. Well, Abby Fisher's in first, Rachel is in second, and Stephanie Capellos, who's a sophomore, I think, she is in third. She's in third place for Hopkinton. Wow, look at this. Nice. 1-2 finish for Hopkinton.
Nice.
Abby Fisher, lane 4, first place. Rachel Zale, lane 2. Just out-touched the lane girl in lane 3.
Very
from
strong effort.
And here we go. Oh, lane 6. Looked like Stephanie Capellos got a fourth place there.
A lot of people engaging in conversation.
Yeah, it takes a little time for them to get back into the meet. Okay, and for the boys, 100 fly. We have lane 2, Zach Holbro, lane 4, Youngjun Kim, and lane 6, Alex Matsoukas.
That's a mouthful.
Yep. And it looks like they're competing against two athletes from Foxboro. It doesn't look like Foxboro has anybody in lane 5.
I like the Foxboro attire. Very interesting.
Yeah, very
color coordinated.
Very fashionable. Yep.
Very fashionable. Looks more Ryan Lochte than Michael Phelps.
Yeah.
And there seems to be, we're up, we're ready. yeah. And again, this is a very unique stroke. You have to be very, very agile in this one and very powerful in your upper body to take the force of the water, take your arms out of the water, and then back in one almost circular motion.
Alex is swimming some race at lane six. We have first, second, third Hopkinton after 50. And Zach looks really good in lane two. Into the final stretch here, it's 1-2-3 Hopkinton. Lane six, Zach Holbro really, Alex really holding his own there in lane six. He could catch him. Nope, he's gonna get him.
And lane four and six,
Yung-Jung
two
Kim,
comes in third.
Alex Matsukas, Zach Holbro.
Another Hopkinton Hiller sweep.
Absolutely.
Most of the girls, John, that are competing at the higher level, such as your daughter, my daughter, and some of the other more experienced swimmers, although the dual meets are important, it really comes down to the sectionals and states.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, for the girls 100 free, lane two, Julia Gorgel, lane four, Bridget Belger, lane six, Emily Trudeau.
What are we looking at for your daughter, time?
Oh, sectional time is 58.63. And I'm going to keep my timer over here.
Unofficially, of course.
Unofficially, of course. Yeah. But I'm so glad to see Emily Trudeau out there. I was just talking to her mom, coming back from an up-and-down career, I would say, at Hopkinton, and looking forward to a senior year.
Yeah, she's a senior.
Yep.
I've seen her compete for a number of years. Good to see her in the pool. What's the most important split you consider in the 100 free? What do you think? Is it the 25 or the 50?
What's that?
What's the most important split?
I think 50.
50?
Yeah. It's important to get a good turn in this race. There's so many of them.
It is a precision event.
Okay, so far it's Hopkinton and Bridget Belger in lane four in first place. Lane two, Ainsley Worrell, second place. This is a race you want to finish.
Looks like Bridget is competing very hard in this event. Looks so she'll win going away.
And so lane two, Bridget Belger, lane one, first place. Lane two, Ainsley Worrell. Lane six, Emily Trudeau. I couldn't tell the time right there. I was befuddled by a stopwatch. So
We won't hold you to
thanks,
it.
Thanks a lot.
She got a W. That's all that matters.
That's all that matters.
And what do we have for the 100?
For the 100. Boys, 100 free. Lane 2, Brad Canty. Lane 4, Robin Chu. Lane 6, Andrew DeLeva. Now, Andrew's been swimming a lot tonight. And I'll just say, I think he's a freshman. He's got a lot of potential in this team for the future. And he's swimming with Brad Canty, excellent swimmer, Robin Chu. Lane four.
Nice.
Now, for some reason, the timer keeps walking over somewhere else. Maybe there was a late change. I don't know. Mm-hmm.
Little stopwatch malfunction.
Yeah. It's really not a problem unless it's your daughter.
It's those gremlins.
Yes. Robin Chu is swimming his heart out there right now. Lane four. That guy from Foxboro in lane three is pushing him. And then they have Brad Canty here in lane two. It's going to be close. Oh, he's got him. Brad's got a two. Second place.
Oh, nice. that was a buzzer beater. That was a photo finish. I think lane four came in first by a very slight margin. And the next event is the...
It's the 500.
No-doze event. 500-yard dash.
500
if it was a 500-yard dash, it would be probably a world-class athlete probably could do it in a minute and 20.
Yeah.
Or a minute 10, or even quicker than that. But this is going to take a little bit, so... ladies and gentlemen, if you need to get a bathroom break or a drink and you're watching this via tape delay, I suggest you do it now.
Lane two, Julia Gorgel. Lane four, Emily Way. And lane six, Kaylee Cohan. And I was talking to Kaylee's father at the intermission. He said it's the first time she swam the 500 in a meet, and she's really looking forward to it.
I'm sure she is. Somehow I think Coach King is looking forward to it more. He likes to test the spirits of these young women and men.
Yes.
And 500 is a way to test that competitive drive, shall we say, and to keep your lungs pumping. John, this is definitely a pulmonary event.
Yes.
Just 20 laps of the pool, John.
Yep.
25 yards, a total of 500 total.
We have a couple of minutes here, obviously. Just wanted to mention, I saw some pictures at the intermission, and last night at the Hopkinton Swim and Dive Spagger hosted by the Gorgels, there was a great event, and the kids were each requested to bring warm clothes for poor people, I would guess, to be donated to Project Just Because. And
correct.
I saw the photos of it, and it was
it was a very successful event. There was a lot of joy, a lot of giving, a lot of pay it forward type kids. And when you have some of the things that we have in the suburbia town, somebody less fortunate doesn't always get to have the joy of the Christmas spirit. So Project Just Because is the intermediary to have some clothes and some other shelter items for families that are not as fortunate as us. So we thank the Gorgels for their hospitality and their generosity.
Yep, and the entire team, the captains, for gathering it up. I know the Gorgels initiated it, but certainly everybody who participated got a lot of gratification out of seeing all those items that were out there and knowing that because of their generosity, you know, somebody would be warm this winter night. Well, I can tell you we're about, depending on what the time is, we're about a quarter of the way through here. And it looks like Emily is swimming very strongly over there, lane four.
Emily is the bigger sister of Andrea Way, who is a national swimmer. She has chose not to compete at the high school level and does club only, but she is a very highly competitive swimmer, I believe, for Shawmut. And it's sort of unfortunate, but we have to live with the reality we have. High school is only a four-year stint, and you only get it once. So if you compete, we encourage everybody to go out, and if you're successful at it, it's always nice to have a team atmosphere under your belt.
Absolutely. Now, I understood that there was a younger sister, too, who doesn't participate.
That's what I was just talking about.
Okay, I thought it was the older sister.
No, younger sister.
Okay, yeah.
I apologize if I was if I miscomputed, yeah, her, she's a junior in high school, and she's a national figure in the stage. We'll be going on to some form of college participation. Yep. She's here tonight cheering on her sister, and Mrs. Way is kind enough to volunteer timing, so we're happy we have two out of three, John.
There you go.
And we see that the volunteers are showing the number of lanes and the number of 25 yards that they've completed. And once you hear the 19th lane go off, the 18th, you'll hear a buzzer, some type of bell, to inform that leader that they have approximately a length and a half of the pool left. And during the holiday season, it's a lot of gathering of Hopkinton Hiller alumni. Looks like Foxboro has a pretty good contingency here. The parents are here.
Yeah.
And the one main component, which you didn't find 25 years ago, is the cell phone.
Yeah.
Everybody's on their smartphone. Something important's going on, John.
Yeah,
and we're missing it. Imagine
something's
that.
It's real important.
Oh, it's amazing.
Yeah, I remember when my kids first started swimming, I used to bring a book to the meets.
Right, or a magazine.
Read a book or magazine. Yeah.
Something that would enlighten you.
Yes. Now I'll justify it by saying I'm reading the paper.
There you go. I still find myself in the old school department. I was at the dentist this morning, and I read the Boston Globe and enjoyed it.
Yeah.
I'm caught up in that internet craze too, but not from a social networking standpoint, more from informational gathering. But reading such noted newspapers as the Globe or the Times or the Post, Washington that is always enjoyable to go back to a time that'll never come back.
Absolutely. It's coming up on the end here. I just saw the 17.
Yeah, she's looking to qualify. It looks like Coach King is probably trying to get her into some type of sectional or state number. I'm not sure where she is from a timing standpoint.
It's gonna be tough. It's gonna be tough right now. She has to really kick. The sectional time on this race is for the girls is 5:51. And yeah, it's not going to happen. The touch time right there is 5:45, hitting into the last lap.
Unless she jumps out of the pool and runs.
Unless she jumps out of the pool, dries off and doesn't slip and runs, yeah. I feel like, you know, Emily's going to be a little bit disappointed because she's such a competitor.
And another first-place finish for the Hopkinton Hillers
another first
girls swim team.
And I have a feeling that some of these kids from Foxboro are going to continue to be swimming, although I do see a lot of shaking, so it looks like it's closer. Oh, looks like they might get a second and a third, unless lane two, which is Julia, can kick here. Come on, Julia.
And just to keep everything fair, ladies and gentlemen, we have another 500 yards to go for the boys.
She's got it. She's going to get a second place on this. Nice. Oh, the girl lane three was finished. Girl
she
lane
was
three
a lap
another
a,
lap
she
to
was
go.
A couple laps ahead.
There you go.
But it was worth for the audience.
It was nice. They'll know I made a mistake. Really? Having a little technical difficulty. Is it this thing? Can you hear me now? Can you hear us now? Oh, is the battery low? Is that helping at all? Can you hear me?
I can hear you because I can watch your voice. Can you hear me?
No. You're very low. He's very low. Did you do something up there?
Testing.
Testing, can you hear me? You hear me? Nothing.
Testing?
Oh, maybe, yeah. Yeah. Can you hear me now? No?
I can't hear you.
I don't know. Did the battery run out on the radio, on the thing? Just doesn't seem like it would fade out like that.
Testing.
There's another battery in there, yeah. Yeah, much better. Much better, yeah. Oh, my gosh.
Testing?
Testing, yeah, yep. Well, so getting back to the 500 free here.
Testing.
For the boys. Can you hear me? Can you hear us?
I can hear you.
Okay, Greg Ryman, Connor Murchie, lane 2, Colin Fine, lane 6.
And they're off. It doesn't seem like there's... There's four competitors.
One swimmer from Foxboro. Just want to send a shout-out to Dave Franklin, who stepped in the technology.
Saved the day.
And saved the day, as usual. I understood he was taking... He had, I understood he got a very, very rich pension from his times out here, and it's paying off. And he's holding the battery. I don't know what he's doing with it. He's going to throw it out.
He's going to dispose of it properly. He's a good Samaritan.
Yes. Lane 2, Connor Murchie. Lane 4, Greg Ryman. Lane 6, Colin Fine.
I feel like we have a new life.
Oh, my gosh. I don't know what happened there. I was, I thought I was fading into the, fading away. Oh, my gosh, that was something. So you want this one? Yeah, coming up, we have the 200 free relays, and Coach King has given us some kind of interesting stuff to talk about. In each of the relays he has, for the girls, he has an athlete from each grade. So in the each lane, there'll be a freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior. And on the boys' side in the free relay, and also in the girls', he's running two heats on both. On the girls' side, he's got the divers. I guess your daughter is swimming tonight in the 200 free relay.
Yes, she is making her debut.
Yep.
In the 2016-2017 calendar year as a swimmer. Yep. So
she'll make the record books in swimming too.
He's trying to diversify.
Yes. And on the boys' side, he has the divers in the first. No, I'm sorry. They're in the second heat, too. So that's a little fun. I think based on what we see of the score, I'm not sure where this is supposed to be after the diving. It's Hopkinton 66 for the girls. Hopkinton 66, Foxboro 28. And for the boys, Hopkinton 75, Hopkinton 75, Foxboro 16. So barring any unforeseen stroke of something, lightning, we're looking at a big win tonight for Hopkinton. I think it's a true testimony to the depth of the swim program and, of course, the excellence of the divers.
And we're only halfway through the 500.
Okay. I've just been informed that the Foxboro program is 2 years old.
That's what I was going to inform the viewing audience that Foxboro is in their second competing season.
Yeah.
So they're just getting their feet wet and how to compete and how to enlist multiple members and students from their large one high school town. Hush among the crowd, but a few errants cheering.
Yeah, it's fun seeing the kids who swam in previous years around and dove.
Well, this is the seminal meet where they come and enjoy the fruits of their 4 years commitment to the Hopkinton swim team. So you see a diverse college population here tonight because they're on break, and it's a lull between the Christmas and New Year's period. So young men and women try to reconnect, and hopefully they'll give some pearls of wisdom to the current team of how to handle themselves and what's expected of a Hopkinton swim team program.
Now this looks like it's gearing up to be a first, second, and third for Hopkinton in the 500 boys. Greg Ryman, lane four. Colin Thine, lane six, just came in second. I'm right. Because this Foxboro kid is going to swim through, and Connor Murchie will be in lane two, showing a nice kick here, finishing off the 500.
And the next event is sort of for Hollywood entertainment purposes only.
Yeah.
I guess an individual from each.
Each grade, yeah, each year. I don't know how he has it organized, although it looks like he has it organized by year.
Right, so each student from one student from each class.
In each lane. So in lane two, you have freshman Allison Fu, sophomore Paitlin Salyards, junior Rachel Zale, and senior Julia Gorgel. In lane four, you have freshman Mary Lauren Burke, sophomore Sierra Schlussel, junior Mallory Pischoff, and senior Tiana McCann. And then in lane six, you have freshman Sarah Weisinger, sophomore Ansley Worrell, junior Harley Richardson, and senior Emily Trudeau.
And that's only the first heat.
That's the first heat, yeah. When I first saw Harley Richardson, I thought Harley Davidson, and I thought fast swimmer.
There you go.
So there you go. So it'll be fun to see the freshmen competing against the freshmen and vice and further on.
I wonder if her middle name is Davidson.
Yeah.
So this is eight laps of the pool times four. So 32 laps of the pool all six lanes are competing, and the expectations are that Hopkinton will at least get one, two. I'm not sure about beyond that, but it looks like as I talk about the first 50 yards, Hopkinton is in first and second and third place. For relays, the only point totals are for first and second place.
No, I just did my little Mary Lauren Blake, had to hit a 28.9 on the first 50, which is very nice. Lane four. Now we're on to the junior lap. So in the pool, lane four, Mallory Pischoff. Lane two, Rachel Zale.
Oh, I apologize. It was 50 yards per person.
And lane six, Harley Richardson. I let it go there, Ross.
I was thinking. No, that was very negligible on me. I was thinking of the previous event, the 500. So I apologize to the viewing audience. 50 yards.
Mallory just had a nice 30.4 in the second heat. Now we're in the Tiana McCann is in the pool, lane four. Julia Gorgo in lane two. And Emily Trudeau, lane six. Come on, girls. This is the seniors out there. Nice. Okay, lane four came in first, lane six second, lane two third. I'll read out the winners in lane four. Mary Lauren Blake, Sierra Schlussel, Mallory Pischoff, Tiana McCann. Lane six, Sarah Weisinger, Ansley Worrell, Harley Richardson, Emily Trudeau. And Emily swam a very nice heat there, very nice laps. Okay. Did he have any fun for us for the boys? Oh, we have some more girls.
We have the second heat of girls.
Yep.
Diving members of the team.
Yep.
And I'm not sure who else is competing at that.
Yep. So for the, I'm not sure how he organized it, but in lane four we have Amanda Mack, Stephanie Capellos, Kayla McCann, and Kate Lagasse. Although I'm not sure what's happening here. I see boys here. Are they going to run the girls' heats, second heats after? Okay. So it looks like for the boys, we have, I don't think Coach used the same schematic for the boys, but in lane two, we have Greg Ryman, Fletcher Clark, Sam Richardson, and Connor Murchie. Lane four, Jake Glover, Brad Canty, Zach Holbro, Alex Matsoukas. And I have to say, Connor Murchie is swimming a lot tonight. He's in lane two, yeah. Oh, I see what Coach did. I think he made it so there would be 1 second heat mixed. Very nice swim there by Greg Ryman.
Ryman.
I'll get it right. Why does everything come out like I'm living in New York? I don't know. Now, that was a unique dive there by the swimmer from Foxboro.
Somehow you would think at this point that that fundamental would be perfected.
I agree.
Disrespect to the young man, but just that the coaching techniques would make sure
Yeah.
Whether it took 1 hour or 10 hours to get that perfected.
I agree. It can be tough to watch.
It is. I mean, you know, you want it to improve the skill level of each individual so they can feel good about themselves.
So absolutely.
I'm not really sure where that runs into play. But as it all is, we have to worry about our team first. And
yes.
All the other teams,
and right now,
we wish the best.
It looks pretty good for our team because it looks like in lane four, Alex Matsoukas is finishing up. And Connor Murchie is also in the final laps.
Any plans for the new year, John?
You know, they're still formulating.
Fielding offers?
No. Yeah, we're fielding offers. We're playing the field. I have my kids, you know, may make a plan while I'm here. I have no idea. How about you?
Neighborhood.
Nice.
I'm staying in between two neighbors.
Nice.
And not leaving a 50-yard radius.
Nice.
Which is very enlightening because I've been to some interesting New Year's Eve soirees over the 50-plus years of my life, and some good, some bad.
Yep.
But this one is for the kids.
Yes.
That's what the next period of time in the previous 10 years have been for the children.
Yes. It's funny, we used to go out every year. My wife's cousin, used to go to, like, clubs and stuff like that had these, I don't know how we got
all inclusive stuff.
Yes, it was an experience.
It's amazing what a I mean, I've been to Times Square.
Oh really? So have I.
I was there in 1982-83.
Yep.
So it was an interesting,
yes,
as an 18 year old to see,
yep,
how many people you could fit in.
Yes.
a quadrant of
you and I were there at the same time, Ross. I can tell. Yep.
But it had a little bit different flavor, and it seemed a little colder too.
Yes.
And there was no Anderson Cooper.
Yes. Okay. So is Lissy there? Lane two, right?
Yeah. I would say freestyle is not one of her fortes.
Yep. But she looked like she was having fun there.
She better keep her day job.
So we have, right now we have in the pool, Lissy Annenberg, lane two, Amanda Mack, lane four, and hold on, somebody, Jack McDonald, who's a diver, lane six.
Oh, and,
no,
you know,
no lane six.
As things
lane
roll,
three. Yeah, yeah.
I'm thinking that if I know Coach King and his previous history, I'm thinking that he cleared this with the Foxboro team.
Yeah.
Because it's all in good fun.
Yes.
And as long as the other team is okay with it and there's no points associated with it.
Yep.
And it takes an extra minute or two, I don't think anybody's harmed.
Absolutely. I would say, yeah, I would wonder if he'd have to clear with the Foxboro coach for sure. Maddie Staus getting out of the pool from a swim instead of a dive.
And Allie Morrow is competing the third leg. And I believe the fourth leg is Brianna.
Brianna Toko, yep.
And since this is our last sporting event announcement for the year, we'd like to pay our gratitude to all the famous people that have passed away unexpectedly and have lived long lives.
Yep.
In the entertainment field, the sports field, the political field, and you're just pop icons and people that have just had family members that have had passings. 2016, we send out our prayers and sympathy and thoughts to the remaining people out there, and looking forward to a healthy and happy 2017.
Yeah, it just seemed like this year the arts, the music, the entertainment got hit.
It did. Some of my childhood heroes who fit into my small little world unfortunately did pass away. I'm trying to find some understanding behind it and looking for some guidance on why, but I don't think there's ever been an understanding.
Okay, so now on to the meet. Have coming up the 100 back for the girls. We have.
Is your young daughter competing for the remainder of the event, or?
Yeah, she's in the 400 relay.
Gotcha.
But she, Julia Pillarella,
Logan Salyards, and Kelly Burke.
Yep. Just going back to what you just said, the last one this week, Carrie Fisher. And
mother and daughter alike.
I thought that was really unbelievable.
Yep. Debbie Reynolds died today or yesterday. Carrie Fisher the day before.
I didn't realize Debbie Reynolds was still alive.
84. She was 19 years old when she competed, when she made her debut in Singing in the Rain.
Unbelievable.
Imagine your first movie that you're in, you're learning how to dance, and you have Gene Kelly and Donald O'Connor.
Jeez.
It's a daunting task.
I think so.
And from reading the historical significance of that movie, at least for Hollywood purposes, she was overwhelmed and Gene Kelly was hard on her, but she said she learned that it was probably the best way because Gene Kelly's thought processes was perfection. So.
Yep. So it looks like Logan's going to win that race, lane four. This is Julia Pillarella, lane two in second. And Kelly Burke is in lane six. I think she's in fourth.
Correct.
Scoring points for the team.
And we have the 100 back for the boys. Is, oh, my favorite name, Young Jun Kim. And the name that we've butchered throughout the course of the day, Hiretsa Ranajanagan.
Sounds
and
good.
Colin Thine, which is a very simple two syllable first name and one syllable second name. Once we complete the 100 back, we have the 100 breast, and then we'll round out the evening with the 400 freestyle relay.
Okay, just to give us the scores here, I'm not sure what it's after, but for the girls, Hopkinton 78, Foxboro 32. For the boys, Hopkinton 88, Foxboro 18. So it was pretty locked up early.
I think it was preordained. Thank you.
Youngjun Kim is looking good there in lane four.
YJK.
There you go. Actually, this looks like it's going to be first, second, third, Hopkinton.
Boy, that's a news flash.
Yeah. It's at Youngjun Kim. First, lane four. It's like Colin Thine, lane six, no?
Yeah. Are there any, not to sidetrack, but are there any Western culture Y first names, male?
No, I wouldn't. I would say I haven't heard any.
I mean, I know Yolanda. That's the only one I can think of is for a Y.
Yeah.
But for a male, I don't know if there is any.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Just
yeah.
Testing my brain right now.
Okay, as they time it up, we got the 100 breasts coming up. Allison Fu, lane four. Brooklyn Brenner, lane two. Amanda Mack, lane six.
That is a great name, Brooklyn Brenner.
Yeah.
I got to believe there's some New York connection there, I would hope.
Yeah.
As we sit here, and I always used to remember during the days of Welcome Back Cotter, and I used to see the opening scene where they'd say the fourth largest city in the United States,
yeah.
Brooklyn, New York. And then I realized it was one of the boroughs. Oh, the good old days.
I have the profound distinction of having been born in Brooklyn.
I have family that my grandmother was born in Brooklyn.
Yep.
So we know the areas of Manhattan Beach and Coney Island and
nice.
And the proverbial Jewish section of Brighton Beach.
Yep. It's interesting. At a certain point, I think most people came through Brooklyn. At a certain point in history.
I guess.
They stopped there and then went everywhere else.
Yeah. Right.
We said it's Brooklyn Brenner, lane two, Amanda Mack, lane six, and Allison Fu, lane four. So I think two freshmen here. I'm not sure about Amanda Mack, but lane two and lane four are freshmen.
Nice. Again, he's getting experience for the young women, teaching them how to compete, what it takes to compete. And the reality of it all is you can look to the left and look to the right, but it's all about your times. And if you can increase or decrease your times and improve on your times at every event, whether it's practice or the competitive meet, that's all Coach King is looking for. He's looking for achievements and progression and hard work. Because at the end of the day, none of these girls are going to be Katie Ledecky anyways.
Absolutely.
Although some of them are good. Some are good, I will say that. But I'm talking about...
I agree. Yep.
The mainstream. I once saw Elizabeth Beisel compete against my daughter in a big picture meet in Rhode Island once, and she's an Olympian and gold yep. medalist. And she lapped everybody. Huh. I knew that my daughter had no chance.
Yeah.
But it was a good experience, like everything else in life. It teaches you the humility of how good other people can become.
Now, that was a nice race by Allison Fu.
Very strong.
Very strong finish there. Brooklyn Brenner had a tough turn, but she turned it on after that. Came in third. Amanda Mack. Lane six.
Nice finish. As we go on to the boys, this is the last individual meet of the night. The 100 breast, Jake Glover, Sam Cody, and Justin Mack. Excuse me, Justin Mack, yeah.
Oh, wow, I never heard of him.
You know, it's interesting. I've seen a lot of multiple names. Must yes. be a brother-sister and brother-brother and sister-brother-brother combinations. The Richardsons, the Rymans, the Max.
Yeah.
The list is endless. Yep. And that bodes well for Coach King's ability to recruit and keep swimmers and divers within the Hopkinton family.
We're at lane 2, Sam Cody, lane 4, Jake Glover, lane 6, Justin Mack. Well, Sam Cody's looking really good in the first turn. As long as he can keep with Jake Glover. He came to swim tonight. Nice.
And they're neck and neck after 50 yards.
Neck and neck after 50. His family's right in front of us here, cheering him on. Nice. Coming down the wire here, Sam Cody in first place. Jake Glover, Jake and Sam.
Sam and Jake.
Nope, Jake doesn't have enough. Sam's got it.
And another 1-2 finish for the Hopkinton faithful.
And the Mack boy did well out there. He got a fourth place, Justin Mack. Okay, a couple of things about the girls. 400 relay coming up. Coach King calls the swimmers in lane 4 the special K relay. Each one of the girls' first name starts with a K. We have Kaylee Cohane, Kate Lagasse, Kelly Burke, and Kayla McCann, lane 4. Lane 2, it's got Grace Cavanaugh, Abby Fisher, Bridget Belger, Emily Way.
Oh, that's the stacked one.
That's the stacked one. And lane 6, Sarah Weisinger, Stephanie Capellos, Sierra Schlussel, and Emily Trudeau.
Is that lane 2? Is that the Hopkinton
the
record?
Oh,
do they have the record for that?
Oh, I don't know. I don't think so.
No, I thought that was the record.
From the other day?
Last year.
Oh, last year, I don't know.
Lane 2. Almost 3 out of 4, Lydia Franklin. So we're looking at a time to beat of 3:47, John.
Uh huh.
And there's a hush. There's a hush amongst the ranks. 100 yards up. Four laps of the pool each.
Now
and
you see Coach King standing there with his clock. He's keeping an eye out on what's happening out here for sure.
Who's the first leg in lane 2?
I think it's Grace Cavanaugh. Right?
Yep, it is correct. And then Abby, Bridget, and then Emily to take up the anchor.
Thank you. Come on, Grace. Nice.
Two sophomores, junior and a senior in lane two, looking to qualify. We're looking at a state qualifying of 4:02.
Now, Ross, I'm just looking to my left, and I see Dave Franklin here with his stopwatch out.
Yeah, he's looking to see if
some things never end here.
His daughter's record will be eclipsed. His daughter was part of that school record 400-yard relay of Fisher, Kavanaugh, Way, and Franklin. How are we doing on the split so far? Slow?
I'm still having trouble with my clock.
All right. We won't hold you to
don't
it.
Don't go to me. I couldn't tell you. I don't know. I like a simple clock, like on the phone. If we need the time, we'll just ask Dave.
And
yeah, you good?
Can't hear you.
No? I can hear you.
I can't hear you.
Is that better? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Thank you. A little technical difficulty there. Mm-hmm. 336, 347 is the school record. Doesn't look like...
I don't think it's happening.
It's not happening tonight in the calendar year 2016, so we'll have to see when they continue to grow as a team, see where they're at.
So we'll have to wait until next year. .402
is a state qualifying... meet.
Really? Could be a state qualifying.
402.79. And as we wind down the meet for tonight, we hope everybody has an enjoyable evening. Be safe out there. The precipitation is either snow, ice, or rain, none of which are good. So look to the left and look to the right when you... Drive carefully. Make sure all your electronics are working before you get in the car. No texting and driving. That includes you, Ross. And we'll go to the boys just to get a little flavor. I know that we're still waiting for the two Foxboro, but let's just get a heads up here, John. Lane four, we have Chu, Kim, Richardson, and Matsoikis. Lane two, we have Ryman, Canty, Holbrow, and Thine. Lane three, we have Rajanagan, Murchie, Deleva, and Clark. And that will complete the remaining portion of our meet with another successful meet for the undefeated girls team. I'm not sure what the boys' record is, but it's all relative because it's all within the TVLs. They're still undefeated and expected to win, even though last year there was a controversy the last meet.
Yeah, looking at that score up there, it's surprising to me that Foxboro has 60 points in the girls. But it all adds up, it shows.
I think what happens after 90, they just stop counting.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah. And I think 90 is the threshold. So if you get to 90, they stop counting. But if you're, you know, at like 88 and you get a six-pointer or an eight-pointer, then you're able to go over that. But before that, I think they stop. Sort of a surrender rule, shall we say.
Yeah. That I never heard.
That's my understanding of how the point system works. If you've accumulated 90, they don't really care after that because that's the winning total. It's a lot different than losing 70 to nothing in football. I think the good thing about this meet, John, was that a lot of young participants got to be in multiple events. And that's always helpful because we're still in the calendar year 2016, and they have been in the pool quite frequently. Hopefully, they'll learn from the experience and grow from it. But at the end of the day, we need some competition to at least extend and see where we're at, because swimming against yourself sometimes is hard.
Absolutely. Yeah, I think it's a good testimony to the depth of the Hopkinton team that so many kids, it seemed like we were having difficulty with the pronunciations, but it seemed like a lot of new faces, young faces.
And what they usually do, and this has been generally the theme over the past 4 or 5, 6 years since I've been around, is that they usually have an exchange student or two that want to compete, and swimming or track are usually the best ones because those are universal.
Yes.
Basketball and football and baseball, you know, they're American sports that have become universal, but yep. Track and swimming have always been universal. So if you're in Italy or Greece or wherever you are as an exchange student, you feel comfortable if you've learned how to swim as a youngster, because the only difference is the meters and the yards.
Definitely, yep.
But water tastes the same.
Yeah. I think the next couple of weeks are going to be interesting for the Hopkinton team. I think it's undefeated at this point. At least the girls, right?
Right. Well, it's kind of hard. It's within the Tri-Valley, they're undefeated.
Exactly.
Individually, girls are undefeated as a girls team, and then the boys have had, I think, one or two losses.
Yes. But I think what you see out here is a good example of Coach King using everybody out there, kids having a little fun at it, putting the K squad in there, the special K's, and then having the divers. That was, I think kids will laugh about that, but they'll remember that this is all about having fun.
Right.
And but I am continually impressed by the boys that are out there swimming and diving. I mean, I know for a fact one of the divers, Liam McGinnis, this is his first year ever diving. And while he may not be
artistic
enough, he's still scoring points for the team somehow.
Right, as opposed to other teams that don't have any competitors. So it's a testament to his will.
I give him a lot of credit. And the same thing with some of these swimmers. You know, I've been watching Connor Murchie swim, you know, for 7 years or something, and he's getting some very good swims in on the boys' side. He's a sophomore.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I just saw a kid come in the gate there with a book.
Book and a light attached to
light,
it.
Reading light, yeah.
How?
Did he just step out of the 90s?
even prior. I did see that. I thought that was pretty marveling.
Is it Back to the Future out there in the... Did the professor, was it any of the professor in that movie just pull up in a DeLorean?
Yeah.
Doc, that was his name.
It was. Doc McGee.
Yeah.
Formerly known as Iggy on Taxi.
Oh, yeah.
James Igatowski or something like that. That's a dating itself, Taxi.
I guess we'll wait for the final score. Is that what we should do?
The final, not so much the final score. They'll give the final score, usually we just, the only thing in doubt from past experience is what type of cheer they're going to engage with the Foxboro faithful. But it looks like there's a lot of youngsters coming in from somewhere. I'm not sure if they're swimming afterwards. This is a pretty organized pool.
Oh, good, yeah.
Pretty organized pool, so we'll keep it in tune, and this gentleman is going to complete the tour of duty for the night.
How are you?
With a victory to the Hopkinton Hillers.
Just seeing another parent of alumni and current swimmer Scott Richardson out there.
Alumni and current,
yep.
I saw three Richardsons competing this evening.
Yeah. Unbelievable.
They are definitely cheaper by the dozen.
Yep. And, of course, a special thanks to Dave Franklin, once again, the technology guru. Yep. Somehow we don't know anything about batteries in our group anymore.
Oh. And the only thing left is the... Only thing left is the chair.
Okay, so the final scores, is that it?
We did 90 to 72 girls, 88 to 64 boys.
We'll sign off now, I guess, right? Should we?
We are going to sign off. Everybody have a safe and wonderful evening.
We'll see you next year.